do think it's very important that philosophy and science are in fiction, embedded in some way, and organically is the best way. I'm Jeff VanderMeer, and I think I'm probably best known right now for the Southern Reach Trilogy, Annihilation, Authority, and Acceptance, which chart the progress of this strange, creeping, pristine wilderness that the secret agency is trying to figure out what's going on inside of and kind of stop from progressing, so to speak, since it doesn't seem to be particularly friendly to human beings. I've also written a lot of nonfiction, the world's first writing book that has almost all visual elements called Wonder Book. And I read a lot of on environmental themes for the New York Times and other publications like that. When it comes to research, there's a lot of different approaches, I think, especially when it comes to the science. I truly believe that there needs to be a personal element, so it really helps me that my dad's an entomologist and research chemist, that my stepmom is one of the world's foremost researchers in lupus, my mom was a biological illustrator, my sister is in environmental science, my daughter, Erin Kennedy, is now in environmental science. She just wrote a chapter of the World Wildlife Fund's report on sustainability. So there's that. You're steeped in it. You don't really think about it. You know what a scientist's life is like, for example, and so you don't have to research that. But on the other hand, if I am going to do research specific to a book, I try to make it organic by doing that research in vast quantities and doing it vastly before I'm actually going to start writing anything. So hopefully I've internalized it and it comes out in an organic way. And then I can always go back and fact check what I've written. But what I don't want to do in a rough draft is be thinking too much about the research when I need to be thinking about the characters, the situation, the setting, and things like that. So it just depends on the book and it depends on the individual as to what your entry point is. I think a sense of place is really important, in part in terms of environmental activism and all that. So what I would recommend for people is that you may not think there's a place that's your own, but even if you live in an urban setting in an apartment, there's an ecosystem around you, there's a biosphere around you, and there's more life there than you might expect. And you can find an entry point into science that way, or some other aspect of science in the place that you live. No matter how mundane it is, it doesn't have to be an unspoiled wilderness for you to get into that mode and start exploring things in a useful way. I know from being the son of a scientist that science is, yes, it's about facts, but it is about the sense of wonder in a way about the universe. It's not something that's set in stone. Science is always changing because new facts are always coming in, new research is coming in. And I think that's something I wanted to convey in my books and that I think people should think about with regard to science in general, is it's not this set, closed vessel. It's this vibrant living thing that's always changing in a good way. And that doesn't make it less factual. That makes it more alive and more relevant. You hope that fiction can effectuate change. I think it may just simply be more the onslaught of Annihilation and other books as well, the fact that there are so many now. If you can find a useful, interesting way to use science in your fiction, it's a real blessing for the reader.